In today's video, we are going to go over a little bit of tea that has been released after the Valentine's update, and we're going to talk a little bit about this beautiful new set, the colours that you can select in order to make it look just like how Ready the Teddy displayed it inside of the pictures in the shop and on Twitter. And also, we are going to talk about the new halo, the process for making this entire update, and some other little bits and bobs. Let's go. Hey guys, we're aiming to hit 60,000 subscribers before the end of February. If you enjoy my videos, don't forget to hit subscribe and click the bell to help us get there. Enjoy! Hello wonderful little beans, my name is Bea and welcome back to another video. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day today as always. I know I am and I am so glad to be back. Normal recording again, back to normal videos for Monday. As you guys know, obviously, the update normally throws everything off because everything gets so crazy whenever an update comes out. And we all stream and make loads of update videos and I am so pooped. I have been so busy. I also haven't even had time to reinstall my shaders because I had to uninstall them because they broke. But I will be reinstalling them, you guys, and they will be super pretty again, don't worry. But for now, especially with the new Valentine's lighting, I don't necessarily need them super bad, but I definitely will put them back on again very soon. And now that the update is over and done with, I did want to let you guys know that on my Basically Bea channel I am going to be posting again. I'm super duper excited. I'm so hyped to start recording for that channel again. There's going to be Bloxburg roleplays with me and Logan as always, and I'm also thinking about doing some Brookhaven on there, since you guys have been talking a lot about Brookhaven and I actually do have some ideas for some videos for it. So let me know if you are interested in that and be sure to go and subscribe to that channel. There is a link to the channel in my pinned comment on this video. If you scroll down, you'll see a link to the channel. Please go and subscribe and then hopefully you will enjoy coming over and seeing some of that roleplay and Brookhaven content. I have one story about a specific type of person I really want to represent you guys in Brookhaven, so I'm really excited about doing that and I'm excited to share that to you. So be sure to come on by if you would like to. I'm really hyped and hopefully we'll have a really good time recording that. Personally, I am very excited, so I'll hopefully see you over on that channel.
Hey everyone, I'm Dolly. Welcome back to another video. I know you guys really wanted me to come back into the videos again, and I know you have missed me, so I wanted to say hi everyone. I have been super busy and somewhat a little bit sick as well recently the last few days, so I took a bit of time off, which means I haven't posted yet about the new update, but trust me, I am going to. I've just honestly been so busy, but I'm definitely going to do a video talking about the entire update to upload to my channel. I know it will probably be late, so I'm super sorry, but I hope you guys enjoyed watching Bea's updates on the all of it, really, just everything that came out. I hope you enjoyed them, and I'll definitely make some videos on it too.
Well, sure, little bean, so make sure you go and subscribe to Dolly's channel. It's called Royal Dolly. Dolly doesn't post as often as I do because I post a lot every single day, but she just likes to post straight to the point videos covering lots of stuff with the game so that you guys can just get all the information you need from one video every now and again, just covering bits and bobs. But if you guys would like her to post more, definitely go over there, subscribe, click the bell and leave likes on her videos, because the more support she gets, I'm sure the more excited she'll feel about making more videos.
Absolutely.
Exactly. So you guys, welcome back to another video anyways. I do want to say a massive thank you to today's video shout out, which is on screen now. Thank you so much for being so wonderful and commenting on the last video. I really do appreciate it. And you guys, I wanted to remind you, because I don't think everybody knows yet, so I'm giving you guys a couple days to let you know. If you want to be the future video shout outs, make sure you put hashtag LBSO on the end of your comments. It means little bean shout out. That way I know you want to be included, because I know some people don't always want their comments to be shown on screen. So make sure you put that at the end if you want to be able to be a comment shout out, so I know that you guys want to be in the future videos and obviously showcase in a video. I will be doing a shout out obviously using that hashtag from tomorrow. So from Tuesday, all my shout outs have to have the hashtag in. So be sure to comment it with the hashtag at the end of your comment if you want it to be included in the video. Now you guys, I'm excited because the update obviously just came out a couple days ago. There's been lots going on. I know lots of people have been talking all over Twitter and YouTube, but there's obviously been some really big positivity. There's been some negativity. There's some things that have upset some people. And I think that talking about that isn't going to like help the situation. I don't think talking about that publicly is going to help at all. So if you are someone that's doing that, I highly suggest if you have any problems with the update, regardless of what those problems are, please contact one of the devs. They are so receptive to fixing things, to helping out. If there's any issues whatsoever, they will do their best to fix them. So I definitely think that would be a much better idea rather than making issues public, because if you make them public, the devs can't really help you. And it just ends up this whole thing where people are all replying to it and it gets really confusing. So if you guys need some help, be sure to go and do that. And I don't know if you guys have noticed, but you can clearly see that I'm feeling a bit jealous of all the people with their new Valentine's halos. So I'm wearing my Christmas halo, which was made by Jam Jam instead, because it's the closest I can get. The Valentine's 2021 does not match my outfit, so I just can't wear that one right now. So I'm wearing this one because it's the closest thing to Jam Jam's current halo for Valentine's that I can get. And I'm just pretending, you guys. So pretend along with me. Just ignore the trees and we can pretend that it is a Valentine's halo. So you guys are here because you want to hear some tea, and I do have a little bit for you of all of the stuff that is going on in the game right now and in the community, and some interesting information regarding the NPCs in the game, particularly one NPC that we've had in the game for a little while now and I think you might find interesting. So I'm going to go ahead and share this to you guys and see what you think. So first things first, in case you guys were interested, Reddit the Teddy recently tweeted out though here with the set obviously picture release for the final version of the set for us all to see after the set came out, but it's not this tweet in particular that we want to talk about. Lots of people replied to this tweet asking for the exact colours so that they can make their set look just like the way she coloured it, and she did come through with the colours, you guys, and if you are interested, these are the RGB colours, or actually, more specifically, these are the hex code colours. She did link in the replies a website, and if you go to this website, you guys, you can actually click on it, press on the little letters and numbers, which are the hex codes, and change the button from hex to RGB, and then it will tell you what to type in the game inside the infinite colours palette in order to get it. I'll show you guys real quick how this works. So basically, in the game, if you head on into dress up, I am actually wearing the colours right now. You need to go to the infinite colors palette, you guys, and when you are here, you can select one of the colors, select obviously this area here where the RGB is, and as you can see, it will be blank for you, but for me, it's not because I've already put the color in, so let me go ahead and press done and open it again so you can actually see what I'm doing. So the first color, you guys, is actually 153109 76, as you can see, and that is how it tells you. You type it in with the commas in and it makes the color the correct color for the set. I think I might just do it a little bit lighter in there just to make it look a bit cute. But as you can see, obviously, these set colors are pretty much the same. I don't know if that's the order she used the colors, but I mixed the order a little bit to just add a little bit more browning to the skirt. But you guys can make it look the same, but I'm also using the lighting changes inside the YouTube settings, which will make it look a little bit different. But of course, you can do the same things to make it look super nice. So go ahead and have a look, check out what there are, and see what you like. Obviously, you can make it look however you want it to look. It's up to you. But personally, I thought this was super, super cute. Thank you so much, Reddy, for providing us with the hex codes. Next up, you guys, Jam Jam recently tweeted, "Hello, everyone. Are all your paper umbrellas culturally correct for Lunar New Year? I'm sorry if that's the wrong way to ask / describe. Please don't the answer if you celebrate the holiday." Now, originally, I wasn't going to include any of the things that they are putting in or changing inside of the update, because as you know, they are updating some things to make them a little bit more culturally acceptable and more appropriate for the game so that they're not incorrect. They want to make sure that all the cultures are represented well, so they're taking advice from everybody. And you guys, they did do their research before, but everybody makes mistakes and they just want to fix them. The only reason why I decided to include this in the video is because somebody actually replied and did say that this is in fact relevant to Lunar New Year. And I was excited because this is so beautiful. Just look at this, you guys. This is so gorgeous. And I know that this is kind of like a parasol, and I don't know if this is something that they're going to add as like a hand accessory or if they're already in the game somewhere, maybe on like the actual buildings. But whatever they're doing, I would love this as a hand accessory. I would definitely like more things for other Asian cultures, because obviously right now we only have the cherry blossom set, which is actually Japanese, which Japanese people do not celebrate Lunar New Year, you guys. They are an Eastern Asian country that doesn't actually celebrate Lunar New Year. So therefore, the kimono and the cherry blossom set isn't actually relevant to Lunar New Year, which is why I chose not to wear it, because I don't want to incorrectly represent the culture. But as you can see, this is a beautiful little, I guess it's a type of parasol. It does have a special name, but it's really beautiful, and I would love this in the game. I really, really want to help any way I can to represent other cultures, which is why I chose for now to just wear the new set in my videos. I don't want to try to culturally appropriate or wear anything that wouldn't be appropriate for specific cultures. Not that any of the outfits were intentionally added for that reason. Obviously, the cherry blossom set was not added for Lunar New Year specifically to be a celebration of Lunar New Year. It is a kimono set, obviously, to celebrate Japanese culture and not to celebrate Chinese or other countries' cultures. But you guys, this is a beautiful, beautiful accessory item that could be added to the game, and it would definitely help to represent those cultures a little bit better, and I think that's really nice of the devs to think about. They do care. I know some people think that they made issues or made mistakes and didn't research enough, but they wouldn't try to fix it if they didn't care. So please do remember, they are only human and we all make mistakes, and lots of the devs are quite young as well, guys, so you've got to remember that as well. It is important to remember the type of people who are making the game, and they do work really hard, so sometimes things slip through, it just happens. Now let's talk a little bit about one of our favorite butlers, you guys. We're gonna talk about Zed and some more of the storyline or at least canon connections for him and who he is and the type of person he is. And I thought you guys might find this interesting, so I wanted to share it with you. As you can see, Libby tweeted, "What is Zed's problem? Did he not want to have his own store because he's slowly grown to hate working for the pizza place and all of the deed orders? And all of the dead orders and rude customers? It's like the employers told them they all had to work and Zed showed up because he had to." As you can see, Kate Kai responded, "Lol, he'd rather be skating or eating leftover pizzas." Now, Sticks and Tricks actually replied and said, "Unrelated, but I don't know if Zed has ever stated if he's like half dragon or what. What if Zed wasn't even part dragon, he just looks like that?" Kate did reply, "Barbie had intended for him to be part dragon or full dragon and Ash to be the vampire. I wonder about the other three, maybe one a fairy or merman or just princes." And you guys, I just thought that was really interesting to share with you because it gives you a little bit more backstory as the characters were created, I guess, and how Barbie wanted them to be created. It's really interesting, and hopefully we'll be able to develop the story of them a little bit more in the future when Barbie has a bit more time. Now, next up, I wanted to showcase one thing that I thought was really exciting and proves how much the devs really care about showcasing your work in the game. As you can see, Cupid, or Lovely Cupid in particular, recently tweeted Ready the Teddy and said, "That's my face, I'm crying. This is the face that they designed, included in the set pictures and in all of the promotions for the new set, you guys." Ready said, "Was building the set with your face this whole time and really badly didn't want to take it off, so I decided to just render with faces for once." And as you can see, this is where Reddy was obviously building with the face that they designed, which looks super, super cute. So because the face was so good and perfect for the set, Reddy went ahead and decided to actually keep it when rendering the images for the set, which is super exciting, and honestly, I think that's so sweet. You guys all make such incredible things, and I love seeing them represented more in the games and even in the promo pieces when they release for the games as well. Now you guys, on the topic of amazing creations that you make, we are going to check out some fan art. Now I want to say a massive thank you to Paternot, who made us this beautiful, amazing piece of work. I think it's Paternot. I'm not sure if I said that right, but let me know if I said it wrong so I can correct that. As you guys probably already know, this person has made me fan art many times before, including my end card that is on every single video is drawn by them. This is so beautiful. I love it so much, and you are honestly so talented. Thank you so much for sending this to me and making this beautiful piece of work. I honestly adore it, and you are so talented, and I honestly adore everything you create for me. So thank you so, so much. As always, little beans, I appreciate you so much for watching today's video. Thank you for all of your support. The last few days have been crazy. My channel is currently the highest viewed it has ever been, and you guys have been supporting me so much. So thank you, thank you, thank you. I love you, and I appreciate you more than you will ever know. I will see you all in the next video. Please don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed this one. We're going to aim for 250 likes, as always. And of course, you guys, if you want to see more content, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. We are so close to 60,000 subscribers. And of course, if you would like all the tea as soon as it comes out, make sure to hit that bell so you never miss my videos.
Thanks for watching, little beans. See you soon.
Bye.